You guys are in for a treat today. Get it? Yes, 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 because this is such a sweet treat, you guys. This is our delicious fruit pie with the cinnamon crust. Came out amazing. And this is an awesome fruit dish with granola. So easy, you guys. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, then me and my mom have been on our Starch Solution weight loss journey now for over 5 months. This is our first vegan Thanksgiving. And we are super duper excited because we have been cooking up a storm and proven to ourselves that vegan and Thanksgiving can be both delicious and healthy. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe.
Alrighty, guys, and we are back again.
Yes, we are.
Welcome back to my channel. I'm Star Fields.
And I'm Deborah Ann Bartlett.
And if you're new here, we've been on our Starch Solution weight loss journey for about 5 months now. Mm-hmm. We're all headed into that time of the year, that beautiful Thanksgiving time. And
yes.
Guess what? I am so thankful for this Thanksgiving because this is actually the first Thanksgiving in a long time that I'm going to be able to eat all mm-hmm. my desserts and right. all my carbs guilt-free.
Yeah.
So I am so excited about that. And today we're going to show you one of our favorite treats. It's going to be Mommy's creation, her delicious
fruit pie.
Fruit pie, y'all. It's an easy peasy crust we're going to show you how to make. And then I'm going to show you guys a easy little recipe that doesn't require any baking at all. And it's something that you can make if you are a single person this year and you don't want to have to bake a whole pie and eat a whole pie. This will be a little single treat that you can make really easy using some of the same ingredients.
Here we go. For these fruit pies, you're going to need some fruit. So we're going to use apples. And we're going to use cherries. And we're going to use pears. Ooh. And if you have peaches, throw in those peaches. Because I love peaches with mine as well. But we didn't have any. So we got, what we always say is we just use what we have. Just use what you have in your kitchen.
Sorry, I spilled pear juice on my foot.
Yeah, right now.
Okay. So say that again.
So like we always say, if you don't have something, just use what you have in your kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
So I do like to put peaches in mine as well, but we don't have peaches today, but we do have pears, apples, and cherries. So that's what we're going to use today in our fruit pie.
All right. And I want to say that we're using canned fruits, but if you want to cut up fresh apples or if you want to use fresh cherries or fresh mm-hmm. peaches, that would totally work as well. We're just using these canned fruits because it was easy to do. And we don't have all of those fresh mm-hmm. fruits available, okay?
Right.
But no matter if you're using canned or if you're using fresh or frozen, guys, they all have zero fat, okay?
That's right.
And so that's what we're following. We're following the Starch Solution.
Mm-hmm. These are some great recipes that you can use for Thanksgiving.
That's right.
So we just want to give you some tips on what we use here in our house.
All right. So what else do they need?
I'm draining the pears. Bartlett pears. That's my name.
Okay, you guys, we just drain the pear juice into the bowl because we're going to use it a little bit later. Okay, so we just used 2 cups of whole wheat flour, mm-hmm. 1 teaspoon of pink Himalayan sea salt. Mm-hmm. We're going to use 1/2 cup mm-hmm. of tapioca flour, which is also known as tapioca starch.
Mm-hmm.
We're just putting all of our dry ingredients first, guys, so you can see now that all those are in there, she's just mixing them all up. Mm-hmm. We're gonna use 1 tablespoon of brown sugar.
A big one.
A big heaping tablespoon. Mm-hmm. Our wet ingredients are gonna be applesauce, and we're using applesauce instead of oil. So that's 1/2 cup of applesauce. Our other wet ingredient is almond milk. And we're just using 1/4 cup of almond milk. We're using almond milk, but you can use any plant-based milk that you like. Whatever you choose to use is completely up to you.
That's gonna be enough.
My mom is such a great cook.
Thank you, Star.
This is the consistency that you want your dough to be. Nice and pliable. Ooh, yeah. Hey.
pray for each other. Fires, floods, and hurricanes. Life takes us through so many things. My sister and my brother. If it ain't one thing, it's another. That's why I'm praying for you.
This pie filling was absolutely delicious and so easy to make. We took the cherries, the apples, and the pears and mixed it with a half a cup of brown sugar. You guys just seen 1 teaspoon of cinnamon and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. We mixed it all together and oh my goodness, we layered it on top of that beautiful cinnamon toasted crust and it made a delicious treat. Actually, Gabriel ate the whole pie. I think me and mommy only got like a piece out of it. So it was so good. But Gabriel really, really enjoyed it. And my husband did too. So this was something that the whole family can really, really enjoy. And there's only 1 gram of fat in the whole wheat flour per 1/4 cup. So this is really a low fat treat, you guys. And it's something that you can just eat and not feel guilty about. So this was so delicious. Here we just sprinkle some of the cinnamon sugar mixture on top of the pie filling. It is so good. And we also put that on top of the pie crust as well.
Okay, guys.
My glasses got flour on them?
No.
Looks like
that has flour on it.
Okay.
The screen has flour on it. You guys, we have been cooking for hours. Tired. This is why people don't be wanting to cook for Thanksgiving.
I'm telling you,
it's too much work.
We got one more project after this.
Yeah, I almost forgot about
tonight.
That.
Yeah. But it'll be a quick.
It's a quick one. Yeah. Really, really, really quick.
But yeah. I'm looking forward to having a cup of coffee and a sweet treat, our fruit pie.
Yes, that pie filling is so good. We did a little tester.
I know.
And it is delicious.
Yes,
yes, yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. So the stuff you see mommy sprinkling on there was some that delicious cinnamon sugar goodness. It is so good. And the pie crust came out amazing. Did you guys see how beautiful and flaky the crust looks? The cinnamon, and it's got the cinnamon sugar baked into the crust. Oh my gosh, it's going to be so, so good.
Excellent.
So let's go ahead and finish this top layer so we can be through.
Just keep rolling.
Let me go turn him on some music.
Okay.
I'm tired.
I'm tired too.
There goes that delicious cinnamon and sugar again, you guys. We used that so much in this pie recipe, and it made everything taste so delicious.
Put it on 20 because it's not heated. 22.
While that pie is in the oven, I'm going to show you a quick single serving dessert that can still bring you all the flavor without having a whole bunch of pie left over for leftovers, okay? And we're going to use the same fruit that we had in the pie, but this is going to be over granola. So it's going to be absolutely delicious, real quick and real easy. all I'm going to do literally is just take a little bit of granola that we picked up right from Aldi. And all you need is a little bit. I'm going to put a little bit at the bottom of the bowl, at the bottom of the glass. I'm going to take the pears, take a little bit more granola. You guys can do this with just one serving of granola, so it's not that much fat. Then I'm going to take the cherries. Put them on top of the granola. Put a little bit more granola on there. And this is just going to taste so good, like a little parfait, guys. This is a great little treat. And then I'm going to take the apples and put them on there. Okay? And this tastes just like the fruit pie, because you still get all of your fruit without having a million leftovers. I'm going to sprinkle a little bit more granola on the top. Then what I'm going to do is add some of the leftover pear juice. Remember, we strained the pear juice, so I saved some of it, and I'm just going to pour a little bit on top of my dish so it can get my granola nice and soft. So you can have some crunchy granola and some of the granola with the pear juice sucked in. Add a little bit more granola. Eat some granola. And just take a little bit of Ready Whip. And there you have it.
That's good.
And there you have it. Doesn't it look good?
Yeah, it looks excellent.
You can see all the flavors. You have the cherries, the pears, the cherries, and the apples with some granola without all the hoopla. So you can make this for family, friends, and it's really just a little bit of granola. Now, when you're watching your fat, remember, you can have 1/3 cup of this granola for about 4 grams of fat. So this is a nice little treat for the holidays without having to do a lot of extensive baking, okay? A little no-bake dessert. How about that? I hope you guys enjoy this, and we will show you the pie as soon as it comes out of the oven. Stay tuned. Alrighty, guys.
We did it.
We did it. We done cooked up some food for y'all today.
Alright, because we want you guys to have a nice Thanksgiving.
Oh, we really do.
Yeah.
This is going to be our first vegan Thanksgiving.
Yes.
And we hope and pray that whether this is your first vegan Thanksgiving or your 100th vegan Thanksgiving, that you have an awesome Thanksgiving. And
yes,
that's the reason why we wanted to show you how we eat, how we flavor our food over here and season everything to taste.
Yeah.
And we're still going to have a delicious vegan Thanksgiving.
We are.
I think we need to break the stereotypes of being vegan, that just because you're vegan, the food's not going to taste good or it's
mm-hmm.
not going to be flavorful. And I know I thought that before we decided to start a vegan lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so glad that we're I'm proving myself wrong every day because every day I'm proving myself wrong every single day that we make a delicious meal, that these are some of the best meals we've ever ate in our life. So,
yes.
And I know this.
And one thing I am so thankful for, that we are always, what? Full and satisfied.
Yes,
we're
always full and satisfied.
Fulfilled. We are
yes,
fulfilled.
Yes, we do.
With every meal.
Every single meal.
Yes.
Never, ever fails. We're full and satisfied.
That's right.
So you guys, I wanted to show you guys that little parfait that we made just a couple seconds ago. It's done, okay? Gabriel and me, we ate that, we shared it.
They enjoyed it.
It was really, really good. It was so simple to make,
mm-hmm.
so easy. And there's the pie!
The pie, the pie, the,
the
pie,
pie! The pie, the pie, the bling, the bling, the bling! Ooh-wee! Look at that beautiful pie, y'all, with that cinnamon sugar crust. Oh my gosh, it looks so good. Ooh-wee, y'all! Oh my gosh, that looks so amazing.
That's our homemade fruit pie, y'all.
Let me
me show y'all this beauty right here. Do y'all see this beauty right here? Oh my God. Homemade fruit pie. It looks amazing.
We're going to let it cool off and then
we might have us a piece at
have a piece and
3 in the morning. Yeah. Oh, looks so good.
Alrighty, guys, so we love you. Thanks for following us on our journey. Be sure to like, subscribe, share it with your friends. Let us know if this is your first vegan Thanksgiving in the comment section, okay? And let us know what you're cooking for Thanksgiving. Alrighty, we're out of here. We love you.
Love you guys.
Bye.
Bye now.
Oh, she likes a blow kiss.
I like
mwah. All right.
Much love.
See you later. Bye-bye.
Bye now. I'm a girl.